Make sure you stay until the end because we made a big mistake and we want to clarify something. Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a Chevy Cruze, but what we'll be doing, we'll work on Chevy Sonic as well. We'll show you guys the torque specs for the camshaft, VVT camshaft sprockets guys. This is for the variable timing. We guys have more than 200 videos on this car. Our mission guys is to save you as much money as we can. So please guys, subscribe to the channel, like the video and drop a comment below. Okay, let us know if the video was helpful, if you have any recommendations and all that stuff. So, those are the sprockets guys. We have the whole video for replacing them from start to finish, from the very beginning to the very end. So please guys, do check it out. You can find it there. Also, as I said, we have more than 200 videos and we have quite a few electrical videos on our new channel as well. Check it out. So those are the sprockets guys right here. We'll just show you the torque specs on one of them, but pretty much guys, okay, the torque specs are the same for both. So how we guys do that now? Okay, on the back side, we need a special timing tool. We have that one in the description of the video below. We need to place the plate here that goes in the camshaft slots. Okay, need to push it in. Now, what we will do guys, okay, you have to make sure that everything is extremely clean on the inside here. Okay, ours is perfect, because we'll need to install them in a specific way now guys. I'll show you, we'll need to use some special tools as well. You can find all that in the description of the video below. So let's confirm this side now, okay, right here. And what we'll do guys, okay, now the engine, okay, right now, okay, we have that thing there installed on the camshaft. It means that the cylinder head is ready for TDC, but on the crankshaft we're 60 degrees off, and I will explain why. Okay, let me show you quick here. On the crankshaft we're 60 degrees, okay, right here, instead of being here, we're at about 4 o'clock here instead of being at 6. This is so the pistons go down and we don't smash a valve or something while getting them tight. So what do we need to do now guys? Okay, first step, okay, we need to get these guys, okay, and on each, okay, this is the left one, this is the intake, okay, you're going to have a dot that's sticking out, this one, and on this guy right here, okay, you're going to get one circle. Okay, trying to focus, okay, on this dude. So they need to come kind of like that. Okay, they'll pass each other barely, but not much. So I'm going to go ahead, you need to have the those plastic tubes inside. That's very important. Camshaft seals in place. Okay, so let me adjust everything here. Okay, need to spin it a few times. Okay, make sure everything's good. Now I'm going to bring, okay, that dot about right here and the other dot from the other tooth. Okay, to see, okay, it's approaching about right here. Now guys, you need to use the special timing tool. Okay, it looks like that. This one goes right here. That arrow, it's practically almost even with that dot, just passing a little bit clockwise. Okay, and this guy right here now, okay, this arrow needs to come with the other dot. Okay, so let me show you now what we have here guys. Okay, you can see this and this dot are just barely, okay, passing each other, that's fine. And you have the, okay, you have that line here, that's pretty much between the two. So this is it guys, practically, okay, you can see we cannot move much at all, everything's locked in place. Now, what we're going to do, we'll get the bolt guys, okay, we have two bolts, every time you have to use, okay, brand new bolts for that work, brand new bolts. And we'll just go ahead, okay, install this one now, and we'll do one at a time and I'll show you guys, okay, what we need to do. I'll just start them by hand, okay, that way the sprockets cannot fall off while we're doing all that stuff. So I'm going to get a Torx 50 socket. Torx 50. Start looking a bit and... just get it tight like that. Okay, one more here. Okay, you can see this is getting to the point that it just tied by hand. And then, guys, okay, we'll need to get after that. Okay, we'll just demonstrate on one of them now. We'll demonstrate on the rear one, but the front one is the same way. We need to get an open wrench. Okay, for right here now. Okay, this is a hexagon here. We need to get an open wrench that fits. And this is a two-man job now. One person needs to hold the camshaft, even though we have the locking plate and this mechanism, you still need to hold it to prevent damage. And I'll share the torque specs with you now. So first step, guys, we get the torque wrench with the same two. Okay, perfect. We're going to set it at 50 newton meters. Okay, 50. Okay, newton meters, guys. So I'm at... okay, right now, I'm at 47. 50, right here. 50 newton meters. What we need to do now, guys? This is a click type wrench. What that means, when we reach the torque, you see the wrench move and click. Once it clicks, immediately stop. Otherwise, you're going to put too much torque. One person is holding with an open wrench on the other side, and listen now. That's it, guys. We stop. What do we need to do next? Let me get the big tools in action. Okay, I'm going to get a breaker bar like that. Don't use your torque wrench because you'll damage it for the next step. Next step, guys, we need to do 150 degrees. Okay, what is considered, guys, 150? Looking at the wrench that way, 180 is, imagine it's half revolution, 180. This is like on a clock, if you're looking, starting at 12 o'clock, you'll go 180 to 6 o'clock. So 150, guys, will be around 5 o'clock, guys. So we need to go, okay, from that all the way to like that position right there. But in our case, I won't be able to do that. So what I will do, okay, I will start right here. And then I will stop, okay, at about right here at 90 degrees. And then, guys, I will go 60 more. So let's do that now. Perfect. 90 degrees. Now, guys, I'm going to go 60 more. Okay, what is considered 60 degrees? 60 is like 1/6 of the revolution. So it will come, guys, okay, to about, okay, right there. This is it. Okay, so 150 degrees was the second step. What is after that, guys? Third step, it's just 15 degrees. Okay, 15 degrees, it's very small amount, guys. Okay, think of it that way. 90 will be right here. That's quarter of revolution. 15 is 1/6 of 90. So we'll just barely move, okay, to about right here. This is it, guys. Those are the torque specs for the camshaft sprockets. So now, the caps, guys. Okay, the cap, you need to put a new seal every time you replace it. So new seal on that cap. And we're going to get this one tight now, guys, okay? We're going to use the torque wrench again. And ours, we need to set it at 30 newton meters. Okay, 30, 30 newton meters. So this is 27, 30, right here. And I'll go ahead. Okay, get it tight now. Listen for that. Okay, for that click, and we stop immediately. Okay, guys, now you don't want to be, okay, like us. What we did, we forgot to place that cover behind the camshaft gears. As a result, now we have to take everything apart and we have to buy two more bolts. Two more bolts, quite a bit of money, guys. So do not forget that, okay? Do not forget that because you see how we screwed up. So we'll go ahead, order new bolts, and we're just going to put the cover. Okay, it has only four bolts, but if you guys remove that cover, don't forget about it. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching, guys. Hopefully the video will be helpful to some of you. Please hit that subscribe button for more videos and see you guys next time.